Hi everybody and welcome to the CodeRage 2019. My name is Xavier Martinez, Embarcadero en BB from Andorra. In this presentation, I will show you how to use one of the newest units included in Delphi. This unit is JSON serializers. This unit we will help use to customize our serialization. Well, let's go to the demo. Well, we have here this class, the person, with some properties and two methods to do the serialization, to JSON string and from JSON to string, from JSON string, sorry. First of all, we need to know that this unit works with the private part of the class. If we execute the application, we can see that. We have the values from private section of the class. Okay. If we want to work with the public section, we need to specify with this attribute. And if we see this class need at this enumerator, and this enumeration have three possible values. Fields is the default value, and get all fields from the private section. Public is the same of fields, but with the public section. And in is the opposite of the others. It only returns the values specified by JSON in attribute. We will see now in an example. We have seen the default behavior already. Now we will see behavior with the public enumerator. To declare it, we need to use the JSON serialize attribute. We can write the JSON serialize attribute or the JSON serialize only. If we run now the application, we get the name properties of public section. See, p2, address, creation date, display name, etc. And if we want to return the specific fields, we need to use the in enumeration, like this. Okay, if we run the application, we don't get any result because we don't have specified anything. If we want to return something, we need to use, for example, we change this. We need to use the JSON in attribute. Now, if we run application, we get only the P1 property. Perfect. And if we want to exclude some fields, we need to use JSON ignore attribute. And if we run this, we get all fields except P1. See, P2. account ID, address, etc., but not P1. Okay, now we will know how to include or ignore properties. But what happened with our enumerations? For example, this, the gender. To see it, we will to see it more easily. We will use the any attribute here. With specifying gender, like only result with JSON in attribute. Okay, we run the application now, and we get only one result, and we can see that we get zero string instead male. What we can do to get male string? We need to define a converter. Let's go to see how. We will use the JSON converter attribute to convert result. Now if we execute the program, we will get male, and if we put female, we will get female. Perfect. And if we get if we'll put something like that, we will get oh, an error. How to solve it? For this purpose, we need to create a new class inherits from the JSON enum name converter, and rewrite this method by JSON. That we do is check if ordinal value of a value constant is greater than hide the gender. If true, we return an error here. Else, we inherited the normal behavior. And now it only remains to change the class to using the converter. We get our class. And we change the converter with our class. And if we execute the program, sorry. If we execute the program, we can change male and we get undefined gender. Perfect. Until here, the explanation of the use of this unit. Thank you very much for watching it. If you want to download the demo, you can download it from cadetil.com files code rage 2019 json demo .zip. Thank you very much, and so on.